remain all night upon the tree. But thou shalt, and is that?
Yeah, that's right.
In any wise bury him that day.
That's right.
For he that is hanged is accursed of God, that thy land be not defiled, which the Lord thy God giveth thee for an inheritance.
All right. Now, this is what the law produces, our merited work. Here's what it produces, a curse. Curse. Now, the law was there, and it's God gave it. It's for real. And if you didn't fulfill the law, then you're going to be cursed. So, there had to be somebody to be cursed in order for you to be blessed, because you were a cursed sinner, you and I. Somebody had to be cursed. Now, this is what many, this was an eye-opener to me when I got saved. After I got saved and started studying the Word. Galatians 3 and 10. For as many as are of the works of the law are what?
Under
the curse. Every time you try and work out something from grace, you are under the curse. High heels, you. Oh,
Lee, don't go there.
Every time you're trying to work out something, Travis gonna throw them cigarettes away on his own. Who else? What up? You know, get my thoughts on this.
Yeah, it's 22 now.
Okay. So anytime you try and do something to merit God's grace, you are under the what? Curse. Yeah, that's what it says. For as many, it didn't say what era, generation, modern day, new day, Old Testament, New Testament. Anybody that are of the works of the law are under the curse, for it is written, cursed is everyone that does what? Continue not in things which are written in the book of the law to do them.
So,
cursed is everyone that don't keep doing.
Every one of them.
Huh?
Every one of them.
Every one of them. So I ain't doing them. So if I ain't doing them, then the law is coming after me. But again, I ain't doing it. Huh? I ain't got no Sabbath. Whatever. I don't have it. I ain't doing it. That's what Paul is saying. I was a Jew doing that stuff. I don't do it no more. They said, well, you're cursed. But Paul had an answer. He says, I'm not cursed because what? Go to the next verse. But no man is justified by the what? Law in the sight of God. It is evident. The just shall live how? By faith. So, and Paul pointed out to them that we have a substitute for the curse that was on us. Guess who that substitute was? Christ, the one that hung on the tree. He got cursed. He got cursed for us. Got to shorten the lesson, condense it. Christ hung on the tree. As he was hanging up there on the tree, saying, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they do. He was a curse. He was a cursed individual, condemned to hell. But when he went down into hell, that's when he paid the justification for that curse. It took 3 days to do it for all mankind. Now, so my curse was on Christ. Me not doing the works of the law, Christ paid for it. No man is justified by the law in the sight of God. It is evident the just only lives one way. That's by faith. That's by what he hears about the gospel. That's the only way he lives. That's the only thing that governs him. Now, praise God. Let's see. The law is not of what? Verse 12. The law is not of faith. The man that doeth them shall live in them. If you're going to be justified, think you can be justified by the law, you got to live in the law. Many people doing that today. They're living in it. They say one thing, but you can tell by their actions. You're living by the law. Okay, we ain't got time for that. Verse 13. Christ has done what?
Redeemed us.
From the what?
Curse of the law.
Curse of the law. Being made a what?
Curse for us.
For it is written, cursed is everyone that hangeth on a tree. And what is greatly evident for them is that they knew that Christ hung on that tree. And Paul says, cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree. Christ redeemed us from that curse. Hallelujah. So there's really, sister, she can still wear her high heels if she got the faith.
I really did.
If you got the faith. And what's the last one? The only way Abraham's blessing is going to come on you is by faith, that the blessing of Abraham might come on who? The Gentiles through Christ. That we might receive the promise of the Spirit. The things of the Spirit only comes to you through grace from the beliefs that you have in Christ. What do you get when you believe in Christ? Well, some people are made preachers, pastors. Some get works in the miracles. Some get all kind of faith. Some get all kind of spiritual gifts. You just don't know. What do you get? Same gift that I got, Brother Beauty, may not get. Same gift that he got, I may not get. The Spirit is as he wills. But it's all because of you just believe in the gospel redemptive story of Jesus Christ. But grace is a convincing, converting, that's what it does, convince and convert. But I can't see it. I can't see how he's going to bring candy from that red light district.
So you're not supposed to see it. Because word tells us that man looks at the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart.
And you walk by faith.
And not by sight.
Not by sight. Walk by faith, not by sight. That's our lesson.
Brother John, did you...